time you turn on a light or look through a window, you share something in common with scientists who rely on glass in their laboratories. This everyday substance that we take for granted has unique properties that make it ideal for experiments.
The reason that glass is so important in chemistry labs is because it is a non-reactive surface. It doesn't itself react with the chemicals that we use. It's also transparent. That's very important, so you can monitor the reaction visually. And another important feature is that it is thermally very insensitive. So in other words, you can cool it down to very low temperatures, heat it up to very high temperatures, and the glass will not break or crack.
Glassblower John Pace makes specialized pieces for research labs.
A piece of glassware that John made for us are these vacuum manifolds. When you're running an organic chemical reaction, it's really important that the reaction be kept under an inert atmosphere. And so the function of the manifold is either to introduce nitrogen gas into the reaction vessel or to evacuate the nitrogen using vacuum. And the purpose of the manifold is to enable one to control either the nitrogen or the vacuum.
Few glass blowing shops exist on today's campuses, so Pace gets requests from universities all over the country for his work. In addition to creating custom pieces, Pace also mends them.
If the piece of glass is worth getting repaired, in other words, it's expensive enough that it's worth our effort to get it repaired, then we would take it to John. So anything like a manifold or a still or a column, that's something that we would take to John to get repaired.
Researchers can keep lab costs down by having Pace repair glass, a process which turns out to be part art and part science.
This is just a heat up process. If you jumped right on it with a hot oxygen flame, it would crack the glass. Annealing, that is at the end process, smooths out, spreads out the stresses over a larger area. If the stresses were on a small defined ridge, it could crack right on that area where the stress is. Basically, it's just spreading it out, and then the oven heats up the whole item and cools it at a slow speed to where the thick places and thin places cool at the same, basically the same speed to where there's no stress buildup.
Once a repair is made, Pace tests the piece using a Tesla coil. If there's a leak, sparks from the coil will go to the leak and glow brightly. When Pace has finished and tested a piece of glass, it is ready to be sent anywhere in the world to be an integral part of the research process.
A good glass blower is absolutely indispensable to the chemistry department. There are so many different custom glassware needs, whether it be in organic chemistry like my lab, or in physical chemistry, or in analytical chemistry, that we absolutely have to have someone like John on site to be able to address these needs and build us this custom-made equipment in a timely manner.